Now we divide affixes based on their grammatical function, on the function, not based on the form or the shape. So we have inflectional affixes, which come at the end of a word or even in the middle of a word and cause change of the word in the form of the word, not the function. These affixes don't change the parts of a speech of a given word. And in English we have 9 types of inflectional affixes. These are noun plural, noun singular possessive, noun plural possessive, present third person singular, present participle, past tense, past participle, comparative, superlative. The words to which these affixes are attached are called the stems. The stem includes the base or bases and all the derivational affixes. Okay, so the main thing about these types of affixes, they don't change the parts of a speech. For example, the word travel, it's a present. When we change it into past or past participle, we add ed, so it becomes a traveled. So travel is a verb, traveled is a verb too, no change. The verb didn't change to into a noun or an adjective, it stayed as a verb. ED is a type of inflectional affixes, and the same thing with ING, as a plural, ER, comparison, EST, superlative, the, as I said, the ING, the S plural, or the third person singular, as third person singular, or the two types of S possessive.